Welcome back, guys, to The Legend of Zelda Minish Cap. We're having went through several routes here and getting a heart piece within the Fortress of Winds. We still have not found ourselves the dungeon item, but we have picked up two keys. And with that in mind, we head back to the main room, of course, where two key doors await us. Let's get exploring some more. But first, let's get rid of all the enemies. Or at least the ones I need to get rid of to get out of there. Dodge through, skeletons! Come on then, try to attack me. It's fine. We'll take you out without an issue. Now, which door do we go through? Top, middle, or bottom, as it were, or left or right? Let's go for the left-hand side one first. And find ourselves a gap, or not so much a gap. A moving platform with problems in the way. Is gonna hurt us that much, that's for sure. Right. So we've got ourselves two... Wait. I saw the shadow come in. I was like, that's not right. But we've got ourselves two switches to shoot at. And we'll defeat you in the meantime. Phew, okay. We've got hands from above. They're going to grab me and take me out again. They're not so scary. We've gotten more and more used to them, haven't we, as times go by. But this looks like a... a boss room. And so one comes out. Let's get my hit from the side. Should really sucker you into trying to hit me, really. So I can get you from the side nice and easily. Not a problemo. We learned from our first opponent, we get ourselves a warp. And singular rupees as well. No other good items apart from that. Well, we're going to reach our rupee cap soon enough at this rate. Right, we've got rotating spike room. We should be able to keep up with the spikes in front of us, really, with the rolls. Whoa, nerdy roll too far. Get out of here. Take bombs, that's for sure. Any items are good by me, and any very suspicious markings on the floor are super obvious. In fact, this is the room we marked out earlier as saying, ooh, secret room, it's got treasure chests inside. Let's go get it. I was wondering where this path was leading me. It's such a thin path, after all. But we finally found it. You got the mole mitt. Dig, 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 to your heart's content. Dig, 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 I will indeed. We just take things out like that. Not a problem, which means we're going to have to go back a bit and kind of search through previous places. 100 rupees, our rupee cap really is going to be reached. Because we have missed a few treasure chests or switches and stuff along the way. Ones that we could not reach, plus there's rupees in the starting room of this place, which I'm guessing I should probably leave, if you think about it. I should be taking stuff I could possibly come back and use later if I've got a rupee shortage, eh? Why am I going this way? Because we've got door number two. I wanted to head back and sort out those places already, but let's keep exploring. And pull this switch, whatever it is. And that was close, but it was kind of obvious that was going to come back behind me. Phew, we barely made it. I was certain we ran out of time. No, no, with my rolling skills, we'll make it no problem. We could use the pegs. Oh. Don't you try to grab me, guys. Well, to be honest, you're a bit stationary. I was wondering, could I dig you? Let's defeat all of you and make ourselves not a treasure chest, but another shrinking point. We're getting ourselves a fair few rupees. We're only like 11 from the cap now. But I'm wondering if I really need to be small just yet. Let's check the map, see if there's any adjoining rooms, but... Aha, to make it over there, we have to be small. Ow, skeleton guys. Okay, we can just make it through this point, though. We don't necessarily have to be small at this point in time. But we need ourselves another key, so... With that said, let's go around here. And see that we need ourselves... Okay. Right, so what we need is to put two of these blocks down somewhere. So let's start with block one, and by the look of it, I'd have to say the way for us to do this is to start up top and go at angles. So with that said, down we go. And then we bring our after image through and step on. Without much of an issue, we got ourselves a small key. Use it to open locked doors and blocks. You can use it only in this dungeon. But why would I need to be small to pass through there? But I'm wondering, is there any secret chest here or something? Why would we need to be small? Questions. Maybe after we've opened this, we'll find out why. Alright, no reason to shrink just yet, but a massive chest. We could jump down there, but we don't really need to. We could go through, however. There. Wherever that would lead. That's another dark room with nothing inside, it seems. So with that said, let's go. Oh, no, you get me. All the way. See where that will take us, eh? Get on top first would be a good idea. Always keep pressing R outside, because that's how, of course, we get big again. Aha! So the reason we'd have to go through here is because we can now not dispatch. That's problematic, though. If I fall in here, I fall. And I can't just walk under them. Well, I can if I want to. I get hit a little bit, though. I guess I'd have had to walk between them rather than do what I do, but we've got hearts. We've got hearts to burn. We can do it quicker this way, after all. And so with that said, let's find out what's going on in here. It seems there's multiple... Aha! Key, you say? Seems there's multiple sparky friends, or I'd say enemies. We get ourselves another key without issue. Well, that said, we head back the way we came. Shrink ourselves down and get out of here. We don't want any of those guys released, that's for sure. Alright, we could jump down and attempt to make it over to the taller point. I think that's what we will do for now. And then get ready to fight! And take them out, and our rupee total has been completely met. 999 rupees! Can't complain about that, that's for sure, but where am I going now? Okay, guys. I was about to say, can I hit you from here? Definitely gonna be the easiest way to do things, isn't it? Right, we'll take you out one by one. I wonder if these pots have anything in them, but to be honest, haven't we seen this room before? We have indeed. Alright, I don't know if defeating you will get me anything. There is a treasure chest here, however, so with that in mind, let's defeat all the enemies in this room and see if something appears for it. Get myself a hit a little bit, but we can always get ourselves some more hearts. All those guys have been defeated, sure, but no treasure chest has been picked up because it's further along from here or something like that? Or am I not even registered on the map at the moment? That's counting the big chest. There's no more things in here, but we got ourselves a big green rupee. I guess it's kind of good, but also completely rubbish, because of course we've met our cap. If you guys want to jump out like that, that's fine by me. We'll take you all down without any issue and get ourselves nothing. No big key. Because I think we've got to head down first. And we chose the right side, thankfully enough. You got the big key. Use it to open big doors. I'm sure we will in the future. But in the meantime, we just need to head out. Head out and back to the start. Right then, let's work on those few chests that we've not yet got in the dungeon before we do anything else. Can I just jump down this way? I can indeed. Right then. So where do we really want to head for our boss door? It's the third floor, that's for sure. But in the meantime, let's get out of here and look around a bit more. Now, here's one place we can do stuff. Treasure chests are around, and I want them. So with that said, we'll push you onto the switch. And pick ourselves up a blue kinstone piece. These mystic stones are said to bring happiness, I'm sure. And I think this is just the route to bring us up to, of course, the boss door. Or near enough. Getting nearer. Seeing we can dig into there. Or we couldn't pass prior. But to be honest, we want to check all the routes around the side for now. So let's get out of here and go treasure hunting. I'm sure the boss isn't that far off, but there's a whole nother room over here that we've yet to check out. Well, I thought there definitely was something there. What is it? Oh, it's a chest! A chest hidden away, a kinstone piece is ours! I was wondering what I was bashing up against. Now what's about this room? Wiz robes? Oh, and... ah! And flaming torches as well, but let's just dodge that for the time being. Get ourselves 80 mysterious shells for our trouble. Extra chests are never bad. So how many chests does that leave us now? On the second floor, on the third floor, we're looking completely chested out. Mind you, I'm pretty sure I've seen other places that we can dig, so I'm a bit confused about that. Let's dodge these guys without an issue. And check around a little bit more. Because the sandy areas all have places to dig. And they do have chests inside for those eagle eyes. So why have I actually not picked up the compass? I'm pretty sure I have. So why are there still secret chests hiding around? That's what I'm wondering. Well, that one's been taken, it seems. We know that's a like there. Nothing here either. Let's just make our own routes, you know. No need to go all the way around after all. And here we go, here's another place. Now what are we doing with you? We just stand on you, no pressure switch, that's fine by me. Get dizzy, sir. And we got ourselves a red kinstone piece for our troubles. I guess it's stopped denoting things on the map. All the same, all we really want to do now is head back to the other side. And accidentally fall off. Well, we made it all the same. It's fine. I may have fallen, but I didn't really fall. Okay, there's nowhere to go from here, if I remember correctly. So all that's left for us to do is jump down, and have a nice time picking up tons of rupees. All these extra kinstone pieces hidden. Out of sight, and there's the hearts we need to keep replenishing ourselves. We've got ourselves tons of fairies after all, so we should be fine. Let's check the other way then. There's definitely sand to be dug up here as well, after all. Well, you can jump out, that's fine, but we've already done the puzzles to open doors. And I don't really need to challenge you either, sir. We'll get ourselves a red kinstone piece! Anything else for us to grab? Still more sand, still more ow, electrocutions. But another red kinstone piece is ours without an issue. Apart from the electricity. That's generally an issue. Right. So we'll dig through there and enter back to this room, which, if I remember correctly, is just a falling down room. We've already been through those areas, so let's get back to the start. We've already got our heart piece after all. We picked up a fair few more kinstone pieces. So there's treasure chests that aren't even marked on the map. That's a shame, that's a shame. I prefer that they were. Get ourselves heart number one, heart number two. Fill ourselves up fully. And get heading up these floors. Wouldn't you say? Hopefully all the treasure chests have been found, so let's start exploring though. What's going on here? Okay, just a simple puzzle to open up a warp. And straight away the boss door is ours. So let's get looking on inside, see what's there to be found. Oh, I hit the thing? You're kidding me. Right, arrows. Oh, I can't even hit this one. Stop it. Ah! So arrows and hearts are what we're picking up here, which might lead to us knowing what items we need to use, but of course the dungeon item is always one to think of. But maybe the bow's useful as well here. For a gigantic floating head and an enemy I seem to remember! From the Wind Waker? Right then. Well, I can see what the bow might be used for, because whenever there's an eye... Ow, you hit me, but I got that eye. And I'll bust it in the meantime. Okay, your hands are busted. But what are you doing now? Well, let's use the puzzle elements that are around the room. And see that he's got a door as a mouth. Alright, so what are we doing here? Well, seems we're just breaking the pillar with an eye? If I had to say anything... Whoa, whoa, whoa! What's the Gravitron for? Okay, we've been taken out for more danger and more battles, but in the meantime, it seems he can still see me, despite me being in my shrunken form. And I'd guess if anything, like... Okay, you're attacking a lot faster now, eh? Well, that's one hand down, or not so much. I kind of got hit from the side there because I wasn't expecting it to take a few more hits than it did. Shrink down and let's get over. Right, now our dungeon item comes into effect. We have to find which one's the right one to get rid of. By the look of it, it's this one. And we've already got our sword equipped, so we're fine with that. Blow that section up. No, don't grab me, sir. Well, we'd better, before we go out, change again. Is the rule of freeze apparent here as well? Oh, you hit me anyway? I thought I was getting well out of range there. I got hit again for my troubles. Oh, you kind of, like, grabbed that arrow by the look of it. Ah, nope. No hitting you there. Stand still. Right, one's defeated, but we got gigantic floor lasers as well. And we're dropping monsters from above. Oh, for hearts? I don't mind. Right, we know what we might be needing when we enter this room. So, let's bring him down once more. Dodge the floor lasers, dodge the monsters. And will the rule of freeze occur? Will it appear? Right pillars found, it looked like I exploded there. But if anything, the boss is going down. That was one big explosion, but we get ourselves a piece of heart. You've got a heart container. Piece of heart? A heart container, you mean? Your life energy has increased and been replenished to a full 10. Nicely done. Well, 10 more hearts to go then. We'll get them in time, but where are we now? A place full of parrots, parakeets, macaws, whatever you want to call them. And a message. We are the tribe of the winds. Long have we lived with the winds. We have mastered them. Now we join them. Together, with the great winds at our backs, we head for the skies. Those who come seeking our power must play the notes Zephyr teaches. May they lead you onward to the power that you seek. And an ocarina drops from the sky. You got the Ocarina of Wind. North, south, east, and west are all just a breath away. I do believe this is where the Tribe of the Winds once lived. So they've left for the heavens and taking their element with them. It looks like the wind element is beyond our reach for the time being. We have no choice but to press on. Let's get out of here! We may have not claimed ourselves an element, but if anything, we did claim ourselves a ton of rewards. The element was not here, but at least we now have a clue to its whereabouts. You must use the Ocarina of Wind to open a new path. Well, there's no point in standing around. Go get that last element! We must use the Ocarina of Wind to get the new path, shall we? Well, let's give it a go and see where it would take me. Right, we have many a place discovered already. We can walk around quite a few, after all. In fact, we should check that area for any goodies ourselves, but maybe heading back to town would be best first. Where to go? Well, let's get straight back to town, to this wind crest. I don't remember... Did I open one? Did I open one in Lake Hylia? I don't know. Aha! It's that mysterious mark we've been seeing as a wind crest! If you play the Ocarina of Wind, Zephyr comes to pick you up and fly you away! That means we can have Zephyr carry us to any other wind crest we've seen! Are you following me, Oliz? Don't hurt your brain thinking about it! Just give it a try, and you'll see what I'm talking about! Sure thing, sure thing! So, entering town once more, we look out for more adventures in future episodes! As we bring ourselves to an end, beating a boss, getting a full heart container, and a dungeon item or two! Tune in next time for more Legend of Zelda Minish Cap, and I'll see you around. Bye-bye.